your summer tradition and, well, perhaps your best event ever.
What's my record? Huh? What's my record?
7-1.
7-1.
I know you're going to tell us for the next 2 weeks. But from one champion to another, it's the prodigy.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the NXT Women's Champion, Roxanne Perez.
What are you thanking me for?
No, no. I'm giving her props, the prodigy.
I give her props every single time she's out here.
She is truly one of the best in this business right now, today, in 2024. Give her a props, big. Oh, yes, man.
Take for everyone to start treating me like the champion that I am. Last Sunday, I defeated the biggest badass that NXT has, retained my title, added another name to the resume, and you'd think that because of that, I'd be getting my flowers. I mean, the WWE Universe is literally witnessing greatness before their eyes. And what do? They give Lola Vice, the loser of the match, a standing ovation. Hello? It should have been me. You guys don't deserve to watch a once-in-a-lifetime performer like me. You really don't. At 22 years old, I am just so damn good. And I haven't even hit my prime yet. How untouchable am I gonna be in 5 years? Because I'm not competing with anyone inside that locker room. I'm competing with the history books. And speaking of history, because I sure know mine, 13 years ago tomorrow, Charlotte Flair had her very first NXT TV match. And 13 years later, she's a 14-time world champion. The queen, a future Hall of Famer. But guess what? I'm on pace to shatter all of her records. Bayley's, Asuka's, Rhea's. But you know what really, really pisses me off? Is the fact that all the talk online is when Julia comes to NXT, Roxanne's in trouble. When Stephanie McCurry comes, she's gonna run through the NXT women's division. Well, you know what? Why don't you go ahead and roll out a red carpet for them? Matter of fact, roll out the red carpet for any talent around the world, because when they step inside the ring with me, no one compares to the prodigy. Which is why I find it quite laughable that Thea Hale is my next opponent. I mean, come on, she has as good of a chance to beat me as Duke Hudson has to beat Obafemi tonight.
Roxanne! Seriously? No, no. You know what your problem is? Is that you come in here and you sit and you act like everyone owes you respect. But in reality, nobody owes you anything. And honestly, you barely escaped Heatwave with your title. So, I know our paths have never really crossed, but I honestly used to really look up to you. I thought, me and Roxanne, you know, we're really not that different. I thought, like, the fact that you'd even come out here and say that it's laughable that I'm your next opponent, you of all people know what it's like to be underestimated. You know what it's like to have people doubt you. Seriously? So go ahead, Roxanne, doubt me. Because I've broken doubters' noses. I've fractured doubters' arms. I've defeated doubters that I was never supposed to beat. So at the Great American Bash, go ahead, open up that history book that you say you want to rewrite. and then hand me the pen so I can write Thea Hale, one of the youngest NXT Women's Champions.
Aww, Thea, oh, you're so brave coming out here without your little chaperones. But look, I'm not underestimating you. I just know that as long as I'm holding this championship, it's not gonna be your time, or anybody else's time for that matter. Here, let me give you some advice, okay? You're not ready. I mean, coming from someone that knows, you know, I know exactly what it's like to lose a shot at this title. How you just spiral, lose control. I mean, let's not forget when Mr. Chase threw in the towel. Thea, this championship is for big girls, not children. And you can go on and on about how you're a grown-ass woman, but you're nothing but a little girl.
We're on a cheap shot from the champion, but look at Thea Hale. A prodigy. I hear what you're saying, but this is turning down. This is breaking out into a fight. And Thea's right. She's beating down doubters. She's on top right now.
Somebody stop this.
Rich Allen was close enough nearby, but there's one thing for sure as other referees make their way down. This isn't the same Thea Hale that Perez once knew. And can Thea etch her name in the history books? Only time will tell.